you will never find a more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious.
Galaxy's Edge, Disney's brand new and highly anticipated Star Wars land, opened last year in both Disneyland California and Disney World in Orlando. The area is set at Black Spire Outpost, a trading post on the planet Batuu amidst the conflict between the First Order and the Resistance. Galaxy's Edge is a highly detailed and immersive area. Stormtroopers and First Order officers patrol the streets, questioning people at random. You'll see Rey, Chewbacca, and other Resistance fighters wandering through the port, going about their business. All of the details in the buildings and surroundings are spot on. They even got the actual actors from the movies to do some of the video work at the park. Although they didn't use Adam Driver for some reason, and it's not exactly consistent with the storyline from the movies, but the whole idea is that you're set right in the middle of the action of the sequel trilogy, and for the most part, it works. Rise of the Resistance is a brand new kind of attraction that we've really never seen before. It's not simply about just getting in a car and enjoying a ride. It's an immersive experience that puts you right inside a Star Destroyer, going through an interrogation process by First Order officers. And the actual ride itself is pretty solid, escaping the Star Destroyer during a massive space battle. But the real prize of this attraction is the build-up to it, and the moment that you realize you're in an actual Star Destroyer is breathtaking. The downside to Rise of the Resistance is that you can't just line up for it. You have to get into a virtual queue system through the My Disney Experience app right when the park opens. Take one walk through Hollywood Studios at 8 a.m. and the only thing you'll see is people staring at their phones, desperately hoping to get into the ride before all of the spots fill up within seconds. The system will likely go away once the initial rush fades and they've worked the kinks out of the ride, which currently experiences frequent stoppages. It's very inconsistent right now, but overall, Rise of the Resistance is an excellent attraction. The second ride at Galaxy's Edge is Smuggler's Run, a ride that puts you at the controls of the Millennium Falcon, guided by Hondo Ohnaka. I was initially skeptical of how much control this ride actually gives you, but your performance absolutely has a significant impact on the experience. Smuggler's Run features 6 roles: 2 pilots, 2 gunners, and 2 engineers. The gunner position is pretty straightforward. You have 2 buttons to hit, and you can even just hold one of them down for 95% of the ride. The engineers are responsible for maintaining power inside the Falcon, frantically hitting all sorts of buttons and flipping switches, much like characters piloting the Falcon would in the movies, and it's an incredibly fun role to be in. But the pilots control this ride. One pilot is responsible for horizontal movement, and the other is responsible for vertical movement. Quite frankly, if your pilots aren't good, this ride isn't a fun experience. Every time you fly into something, the ride jerks and damages the Falcon. While this can make the engineer experience pretty crazy, it's not a fun way to experience the ride. When I went on as a solo rider, bad pilots borderline ruined the ride for me and gave me a headache, banging into every single thing they could've. But getting to pilot the Falcon myself and send it into light speed was so freaking cool, and it was easily my favorite part of visiting Galaxy's Edge. As most people know, Galaxy's Edge presents you with the opportunity to build both your own droid and lightsaber. The droid building experience is fairly generic, and the droid is kind of neat, but it's largely something that I would deem forgettable. But building your own lightsaber at Savvy's Workshop is a pretty cool experience, and both the custom lightsabers that you can build and the legacy lightsabers of the characters in the movies that you can buy are pretty high quality and make for fantastic display pieces. So while you can do without the droid, I thought all of the lightsabers offered at Galaxy's Edge are well worth the money. The rest of the shops are pretty straightforward. Things like toys, pins, Jedi clothing, and other accessories are all over the place. There were a lot of cool things there that would have absolutely made my parents hate me if Galaxy's Edge was a thing when I was a kid. But a lot of the shops are also way too small and super tight, making it mildly annoying to walk through them. And as for food, there really aren't a whole lot of options available to you. Oga's Cantina is a pretty cool spot to grab a drink or a small snack, but it ultimately falls victim to what I think is the biggest flaw of Galaxy's Edge. It feels like a weird knockoff of something that it should actually be. Black Spire Outpost is basically a mildly altered version of the Mos Eisley spaceport from A New Hope. If the area was based on Mos Eisley and recreated the Mos Eisley Cantina, it would be phenomenal. We, as Star Wars fans, have a connection to Mos Eisley, and it would be awesome to experience the literal beginning of Star Wars. but Disney very clearly wanted to build their land around the sequel trilogy, and it felt like they just took Mos Eisley and changed it a little bit so that it fit that objective. For the most part, Disney did an excellent job with Galaxy's Edge. While I was a little bit underwhelmed and it didn't totally meet my expectations, it was still a great time. I was questioned by stormtroopers, flew the Millennium Falcon, walked through a Star Destroyer, and held my own lightsaber. Galaxy's Edge is an incredibly detailed and immersive experience that I would absolutely recommend to any Star Wars fan.